Does math send your child into a spiral of anxiety? Are you looking for ways to help them create more positive associations with math? You've come to the right place. Many children, and in fact many adults, believe that math skill is something you're either born with or you're not. And once they decide they're not good at it, they often persist in this belief even in the face of evidence to the contrary. From there, it becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy as the anxiety prevents them from applying themselves to learning and developing in math, and so the vicious cycle begins. The reality is that while math ability does vary somewhat from one individual to the next, almost all of us, with the exception of children with genuine learning disabilities, have a basic, innate understanding of mathematical concepts. Something as simple as stretching out our hand to catch a ball actually requires exceptionally sophisticated mathematical calculations in our brain, and all this happens without us even consciously realizing. So a large part of the variation we see in kids' math ability actually comes down not to their actual ability, but to what they believe about their ability. Our role, then, is to help shape their beliefs so that they help rather than hinder their learning and development in math. Perhaps the most important thing you can do to help your child develop a healthier, more positive attitude towards math is to foster and demonstrate a growth mindset not just in math, but in every facet of life. Math anxiety is often based around a fixed mindset, a belief that ability in this area is set in stone. A growth mindset is the opposite. It holds that our ability is always improving as we practice and learn from our mistakes. Teach your child that ability in any given area is never set in stone. We can always get better by learning and practicing. And give them the evidence to back it up. When your child gets better at something, make sure they recognize that. When you correct a mistake, point out that they have just learned something. Already they know more than they did before. Most importantly, practice what you preach. Be careful about the way you respond to and talk about challenges, successes, and failures in your own life. After all, many of our children's tendencies and behaviors are modeled on our own. If your child sees you learning from your mistakes and recognizing your achievements, they are far more likely to do it themselves. In this same vein, make sure you are not projecting your own math anxiety onto your child. As you help them with their homework, avoid getting frustrated or making negative comments about your own ability. If there's something you're struggling with, use it as an opportunity to show your child that we all have gaps in our understanding sometimes, and that this is an exciting opportunity for learning and growth. Of course, if your child is already very anxious about math, the above approach won't instantly make their anxiety evaporate. This is where hypnosis can be very helpful, by working to change your child's belief system at an unconscious level while they are deeply relaxed. Overcome Math Anxiety for Kids is a self-hypnosis audio session centered around a story about a young child called Beth. This relaxing story, listened to at bedtime, will help your child recognize their natural math ability and start to find enjoyment in applying and developing it. As your child relaxes and listens repeatedly to this session, you'll notice that they start to feel much calmer and more confident around math, gradually develop better ability in math, become more independent and better at problem solving, feel happier and more confident at school. Download Overcome Math Anxiety for Kids now and help your child reach their full potential. You can listen on your computer or device or via our free app, which you can access when you have completed your purchase. Click the link below this video to find out more.